All right. That's not too bad. Not too bad at all. All right. Hello out right. Ooh, I'm happy to be broadcasting from our, well, my, our classroom. It feels like it's been a month of feels like it's been a month of not well, broadcasting from my garage. And then there was that one time I was coming to you live from my sofa. That was okay too. Oh, but this feels right. Oh, see, microphone. Forgot my microphone. I'll get that in a sec. So welcome. I'm already a little late. Sorry about that. But getting back into the practice of moving around a classroom and having everything connected and whatnot, it takes a while. So thanks for being patient. I am happy to have, I'm pretty sure my mom is going to be calling in. We're going to talk about writing again. Sorry about free writing still. Because when you go into the break, starting Friday, I do want people to, I'm challenging you to do some free writing over the break. And it doesn't have to be a lot. It could be 10 minutes a day. But it's really going to help your thinking. It's going to help your writing for sure. And it'll probably even increase your reading comprehension too. And we're going to talk about that. So because this is our last, I'm gonna have a reading stream, live stream. The reading live stream is Friday, but then by then I want you to already have these books. So long story short, we're gonna do reading after we do writing. So we're gonna move a little quickly. Sorry if it seems like it's going by really fast, but so does this. Uh-oh, I think I just missed my mom's call. So sorry if it feels like I'm moving this live stream by quickly, but a lot to cover. And I want to make sure I find out what weather books you want by tomorrow or by tonight so I could put it in your trays for tomorrow. All right, so let me bring this to the rug. Need my markers. Need to answer my phone. All that good stuff. Oh, little floor table. How I've missed you. Hello, floor table. Hello, Mr. Corcoran. Oh, wait, that's darn dog. All right, so here we go. So I got my mom calling. Sorry, mom. Maybe I call her. Oh, wait a minute. You know what? I'm gonna do this. Her, but then FaceTime. Oh, that's funny. All right. Sorry, Bob. funny. Let's see. Answer. Hello?
Good morning. I heard Spider-Man, but then he went away.
You heard him?
I heard Spider-Man.
All right. You want a FaceTime? I figure it's one more thing. It's one more. I don't know. Trying to use all the gimmicks I can. Oh, there you are.
Here I am.
All right. So, pardon the view. I'm just gonna get some to set you up on here. How are you?
I'm good. You're back in your classroom.
Yeah, I know. It feels good. It feels good to be in. I don't know. It just feels a little bit more like a It feels a little bit more like teaching, you know?
That's good.
Yeah.
And I see darn dog. Darn dog.
Oh, yeah.
Surprised. Yep.
He's there too. I have a funny idea for Darn Dog, where he's like at home playing video games and he's frustrated with me. Oh, look at that.
I know.
All right. So, whoops. So here's my idea. I told the class, so today, oh, whoops. So it's hard for, I guess I could do this. There we go. All right. So I told the class that we're going to do a little bit about how, what the, so our free writing, right? I wanted to talk about you as a writer and how, just how, continue this whole, how we keep writing to push our learning. Then also, I actually wanted to share with the class how I showed you how to talk type, dictate. Have you used that at all since I showed you? That wasn't your homework. It's okay if you didn't do that.
Bad.
That's okay. I'm just curious because, I really need a better stand than this. I was just curious if, you could share.
It's a great thing, but I made a mistake of not putting a couple of notes down. I didn't take any notes on how to do it.
Oh, okay.
I've just been procrastinating.
That's all right. I was actually thinking about my kids when you and I were talking, because you shared your physical writing, you took pictures of it, I think, and you showed it to me. So I'm gonna draw a picture now of you, right? So here's my mom, and when my mom writes, can you hold up what you write on when you do writing, or you can describe it if it's not nearby.
I have a folder.
Okay, so you have a folder. So you have a maybe I could send folders. Oh, actually, my kids already have folders. So you write on loose sheets of paper.
Yes, I write on this.
All right, so just like I showed the class, because some of my students, I had them yesterday, and what I showed them was you write for an extended period. Yeah, see this? So this is that's how my mom, she writes on loose sheets of paper. And then, but it is possible, because do you consider yourself a fast typer? Not really.
I don't think so.
So that's what.
I don't have a laptop now.
Oh, you have a tablet.
I'm typing on my iPad, yep. On my phone. Right. So that's slow.
So that's sort of what this is. What I wanted to show my kids is that I actually prefer that they, when they write. So I'm going to use green, for example. So when they write, I want them to sit there and just write 10 minutes. Let their thoughts come out of their pencil and just pour onto the page. And when they're done, when their 10 minutes is up, I want them to take a different color, kind of honor what they did, right? Outline it, and then put how long that was. And hopefully it's 10 minutes.
Right.
Because the 10 minutes is the current goal. And I wanted them, I want them to just get used to sitting and writing for 10 minutes. I don't care about what. To sit and write for 10 minutes. And then, let's say the 10 minutes is done. And then they do it the next day and the next day and the next day and the next day. So then they have all this writing, just like you have that writing in the folder. And then they can go to their, you can even do it on a phone, I think. You turn on the microphone, right? You turn on the microphone feature and you sit there and you read it to your computer. And then the computer will do the typing for you. I think I drew, it looks like a light bulb. So that's just.
Was it in Dropbox? What was it though? Was it just the microphone? I had to go to someplace else?
That's the thing. You I think I walked you through and you went to a Google Doc.
Oh, Google Doc, that yep. Was it.
So you go to a Google Doc, and my students, hopefully you're all really familiar with Google Docs now. So we go to Google Docs. And then once you're in Google Docs, you have to turn on the microphone.
Okay, so Google Docs first.
Yeah, and I think it's enable dictation.
Okay, yeah.
Enable dictation. And then what happens is it's like, remember the old movies that you and I like to watch? And they have an assistant or a secretary. And then the person says, take dictation, so-and-so. Yes, sir. And then you read it to them, and then they type it for you. Well, now our assistants are in our pockets. Like, we have little digital assistants. So what I'm trying to do hopefully I'm not too rambling too much. What I'm trying to do is to show the kids step one is you've got to get used to writing with a pencil 10 minutes a day minimum, and then just compile all of it.
Yeah.
And then when you've got enough, of it, take it to a device. Could be a phone, could be like, you have a tablet, could be a tablet. And then from there you can get it onto the computer, and then you can share it with me and your other classmates, and then we can work on the editing. So what I'm trying to do is to show the kids, because 2021 is like a couple weeks away. When we come back to school, this is the process I want them to start using. Pencil, outline, dictate, and then we can start editing it.
Right. So you said pencil, outline.
Or marker out. Marker. You know what? Let me give you my writing journal. Okay, I'm back.
Pencil, right.
You write in pencil. I actually said, now that I realize that, I said that wrong. Oh. Sorry, I still haven't unpacked from the from the latest move.
Well, at least you unpacked the dog, because
yes.
Scrambling to get out.
All right, so here's an example. So here's my pencil writing, and then I do a marker outline.
Right.
Yeah.
So is that your writing journal from this year?
Yeah, this is my writing journal. The thing that I realized, though, is I made a mistake with my class. You know, we were doing writing in here, and then I realized, but wait, we actually do notes and stuff. So if we do too much free writing, we're going to just consume all the pages.
You are.
And then we won't be able to, we'll run out of space. Right. Oh, so here, actually, this is for my small group writing, this is pretty much what I just did on my large chart paper.
Right.
So it's, you write, you take a blank loose sheet of paper, you write, and then eventually you're going to staple it. Yeah. So blah blah blah. That's the main writing thing.
This thing is like falling apart. This is my
right.
All the kids had folders, and then they would keep their stuff in there. So it's like, get your writing folder.
Yep, your writing folder, and then those are your little entries. And you know what? I stole that idea for my students are doing something online called IXL, and I give them, just like you gave your students a writing prompt, I give them an IXL activity, like a standard, and then they go do that. And when they're done, I want them to check that it's done. So kind of like what you just did on a physical folder, I'm having them do it on the computer. Same idea, though.
Right.
There we go. Yeah, looking at my tripod, but sorry. I'm seeing it. But then the kids can see you better if I do this.
Hi, kids.
See?
It's like a little movie with a robot.
Yeah, it really is. So how's your experience been going, either writing or just in general? How are things going with you?
Things are going good. It's cold. And so it's like I'm adjusting to the house is too big to run the heat all the time, so I'm playing tricks with the heat.
Yeah. So it's funny, that's going to be a pretty good segue, actually, because, so our writing topic now is all about extreme weather. And, you know, it's, you used to live, it's funny, you are now in your, more than three, you've gone from Texas to
Texas to Ohio.
Then you've been in Hawaii, San Francisco, and Portland. So those all have very different weather, like patterns and all that. So I'm trying. Oh, let me get my classroom open here, because what I wanted to do, or what I want to do, is I want the kids to tell me what type of weather they're most interested in, so that I can put, like, if kids are interested in earthquakes, which would make sense where we live, right? Yeah. Then I can leave these books for them in their book tray or pickup tray. So then we can just talk a little bit about the weather.
Right. You know what's funny about the weather today? So I'm playing with the heat, right? And when I come out, I turn the heat off. And when I come out of my room in the morning, it's like 57 degrees in here.
Uh-huh.
57 is kind of cool for me. And so, but then I looked at my phone, and it's 47 degrees outside. And I was like, oh, that's not too bad.
47?
I'm acclimating. It's like when I think 47 is not that, I mean... Crazy.
Right. All right, let me get my...
I looked at your weather today, and I think I'm 10 degrees colder.
You're 10 degrees colder than what we are? Yeah, because if I wanted to, I could go outside right now. I could go outside right now, like, without a jacket.
Yes, yes.
Reading
also,
to... Here we go.
Your area, you'll have, like, if you look on the weather app, you'll see the sun... Have sun later.
Oh, we are.
Yeah, you are. We're about to have. There's no little sun thing.
Oh, really? So one of these books is all about that. Because when we have apps in our phone, right? So just to give you an update, my kids in the thread, they're already consumed. They're already, Vihan. Vihan had a great question about Dictate. Let me do that. So Dictate is this, and then remind me, when I finish the little dictation thing, we'll talk about weather apps.
Yes.
So Vihan, great question. You know what? I don't care about dislikers. Stop about the disliking. There's people antagonizing each other by disliking our videos, but who cares? It's like someone in the corner of the classroom going, nah, 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 nah. I don't care.
What a waste of time.
A waste of time, right. I don't even want to talk about the waste of time because that's more of a waste of time. Anyway. Vihan, your thing about what is Dictate, it's where someone, Mom, how about you tell me what Dictate means to you, and then I'll draw it as you say. What's Dictate?
Your voice, you're talking into something. You don't have to write. You're reading it into something, and it's taking your recording.
Yep.
It's recording it.
Yeah, from your voice, you said.
Right, but now if you're using one of these implements, turning it into print.
Yep.
Which is really cool.
So it's talk. The short answer, Vihan, is it's talk to type.
Talk to type.
Talk to text.
Excuse me, I haven't beat my squirrel. He hasn't been back in days. Wait.
All right. So now everybody out there, you see where I get it from. I gotta do this right now. That's. And if you don't, the squirrel's not going
to
come back?
No, I'm serious. It's Walter. I thought Walter was dead.
You thought the squirrel was there? Is this a house squirrel, Mom?
He doesn't come in the house. Your sister warned me of that. No, he's been outside. He comes on my deck. And
okay.
I got peanuts to lure him back because Walter, he's the best squirrel, and he left.
All right, good old Walter. So I hope that Vihan, that answers your question about what did I say? Dictation.
All right.
So now we have a weather. So all I want, Tenzin, Lena, Shreya, I want you to let me know what weather is most interesting to you. So there's some like this, like disasters. Is this something that would interest you as a reader? What sort of weather interests you? Ah, weather.
And snow, but I'm not, because I don't, snow interests me because I'm not sure. It seems like it gets cold enough to snow, but then it doesn't. So what you need for snow?
Oh, okay. Snow. And so the science behind it.
Yeah, the science behind snow.
Snow and the science. Because that's what it is, right? All of this stuff, the reason you said earthquakes. Earthquakes happen because of science. You know, when our ancestors didn't have as much knowledge as we have now, there were stories, right? We told ourselves stories about how, like, oh, what was in Hawaii? Do you remember what the story was about volcanoes? Yep.
Was a volcano goddess.
Yep. So in Hawaii, the people who lived there for thousands of years had stories about how what caused volcanoes.
Right.
And, all right, they, oh, hurricanes. Okay, Shreya's interested in hurricanes. Have you, you and I have some experience with hurricanes, yes?
Yes.
Tell us about that.
I remember the time that we had to go to your high school, and I don't know if you were home then or you were in college, but I'm telling you, your sister was there.
Really?
People board up their, yeah, people board up their windows because the wind is so strong, it'll blow out your windows, and then the electricity goes out, and like if you live in a condominium or something, if you live in a building with elevators, the elevators don't work because the electricity.
Ah.
So.
Okay, so hurricanes, and then what, so right now, I have written down snow, hurricanes, volcanoes, oh, earthquakes. And then, so what, can you use the word regions? Because my class knows about regions.
Yeah.
Can you talk about weather and regions and how they're connected?
It seems to be the further north you go, the colder it is.
Okay.
That's what's from just living living more north now.
Yeah.
It's colder.
Oh, right, because you're in Portland, which is north of California, right?
Yeah, right, right.
North. And north, so what's that midline?
Equator?
Yes, the equator. So like more north of the equator is colder and closer to the equator is warmer typically.
But also the extreme of very south from the equator, way down, like South Pole.
Yes, yes. Okay, let me do that.
Yeah.
So this is all prior knowledge that hopefully my class, if you don't yet know it now, hopefully you know it. I think we did though, because we talked about a Pokemon. You know Pokemon? There's a
yes,
little
yes.
ball. Yeah. So there's a line in the Pokemon ball. I tell them that's like the equator on the side.
Yes.
Right?
That's a good one.
So north is everything north. The further north you get, the colder you get. And then, but also the further south you get.
Yes, I know. Now I want to do some research and find out where that changes, because I know the South Pacific is the warm, right?
Yeah.
So how far south?
Yep.
You can go for it to be cold.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
How far south? Oh, but also, isn't it also not just north or south, but elevation, like high elevation?
Yeah. Yeah.
So like at the top, like I drew a volcano here. Where do you think it's colder? The higher up you go or the closer to the ocean you go?
Oh, higher up, for sure.
Yeah, higher up. So if you go up high, and because my students know Lake Tahoe.
Correct.
Lake Tahoe. So the higher you go, the colder it is.
Yes.
And then the closer to sea level you go, typically, the warmer.
Right. Because I know even on Maui, in one of the islands of Hawaii, on Maui, it's warm at the beach and Hawaiian weather, and then you go up, Haleakala,
uh-huh.
The mountain there, it's cold up there.
Sea level equals warmer. Right, at the top of a mountain. So you could be, so you're in the state of Hawaii, very warm state, but if you go up up a mountain,
yes.
You're going to experience cold, like where you got to wear a jacket and gloves
right.
and stuff.
Right.
What, could you, have you experienced hail? Someone in the stream here said hail.
I've seen it. It hasn't fallen on me. I've seen it while I'm here. It's cool. I love it.
Ah, no pun intended.
All right.
All right, so that's funny. Oh, you want the book hail? Who has? Is there a hail book, everybody? I didn't see a hail book.
Maybe it might be with snow, or it might be with.
Well, that's the interesting thing about hail, and I'm actually really interested in hail too. Hail reminds me of an everlasting gobstopper.
Yes.
Yes. Oh, and Mason tells me we have 3 more minutes. Okay, but Mason, I started 3 minutes late, so it's actually 6 books. Oh, who wants to, well, I don't have a book about hail. Do you all know how hail is made out there? Do you know how hail is made, Mom?
Anybody? Anybody? No, it's
Bueller.
Bueller, it's rain, and then it's cold enough to get it into that. But why isn't it cold enough to get it into snow? Why does it get it into
Yeah, because it, and that's why. And then everlasting to for my kids at home. What is an everlasting gobstopper?
It's a candy that I was always scared when you eat it, you're gonna choke. Because it's the size of a ball. You have it in your mouth and you suck on it, and it changes colors, I think.
Yeah. So it's a candy. And the reason, because when I taught sixth grade, I had to teach all about weather. And the thing I learned, Armand says frozen rain, but it's not just frozen rain, because I think that's sleet. I think frozen rain is sleet.
I know.
So the way that hail is made, it's a special cloud called the cumulonimbus cloud.
Right.
And it's big, right? It looks like it's got a big part, and it's got like, it looks almost like an hourglass, maybe. Uh-huh. And what happens is there's water droplets that fall, but the wind blows the water droplets back up. And then another layer of ice gets around it, and then it falls down. So it just goes up and down and up and down and up and down, like a little piece of candy or a snowball, but I like the idea of a piece of candy. And if the layers get bigger, and then eventually it's so heavy, it falls out of a cloud. So that's my understanding of how hail is formed.
Yes, yes. Well, it has to come out of that kind of cloud.
Yes.
Huh.
And there does have to be the element of wind, because otherwise, like if this is how it starts, right? Because a water droplet just gets so much weight, it falls. But if there's winds blowing the water droplet around, then it's going to get rounder and rounder and bigger, like a snowball a snowball that's rolling downhill.
Right.
Kind of like that.
Right.
All right.
So I don't think you get a lot of hail there, do you?
Very rarely. Actually, in our old house the other house we lived in, we actually had hail one morning. And I went out and I took pictures of it on the ground. But as I took the pictures of it, it was already starting to melt. Yes, because it has to be really cold. Like, it has to be real specific. All right, so we have 10:30, but yeah. I really have to go over some protocol with my kids, because now the Google chat is just blowing up with people saying it's time to go. And before that, it was who likes to play Fortnite or whatever.
Okay.
You know, so it goes. What are you going to do?
It's hard. Yeah, they're not, and you don't know who it is?
Oh, I know who it is.
There is
a trail. Oh, there is a trail, so I can track. Uh-huh.
Yes.
Uh-huh. All right, so tracking the weather. Thank you, Edmund. I have 3 more minutes because we started late. Good job, Edmund.
No, I think, and kudos to the person that's asking, who was that asked the question?
Yeah, who was that?
Because they're paying attention to the...
Yeah, they are.
Right.
It also have to be a snowy hill. Yeah, so Lena here is talking about how for... Oh, I'm getting low battery messages. Lena's talking about how for a snowball where something's rolling downhill, you'd have to have snow to pick it up. So speaking of like our phones and predictions of the weather, so all of this, they use... do you know what they use in order to predict the weather? What sort of things do you think scientists need?
Yeah. Altitude.
Yep.
What is it? Is it NOAA? The National. I think it's NOAA that tracks the weather.
Oh yeah, NOAA.
NOAA or NOAA. Yeah. I think their altitude. I'm not sure about what the instruments are called.
Yeah. So they need. Well, there's a. You've heard of air pressure, right?
Right.
Air pressure is a big thing. So there's high air pressure. Air pressure is important. The computers, of course, are important, because the computers, there's sensors that detect the air pressure, the temperature.
Yeah.
Air pressure.
Is it a seismometer? Is that a?
Oh, seismometer. Would that seismometer, is that earthquake stuff?
Well, maybe it is.
I'm gonna write that next to earthquake. So, seismometer. I'll put a question mark because I'm sure I'm spelling this wrong. Seismometer.
S-E-I-S, right?
Oh, S? Yes. Okay. seismometer, the air pressure. Oh, air pressure, I think it's called a barometer.
Barometer. B-A-R,
yeah. So there's barometer, which is air pressure. We have a temperature. Oh, I'm not going to say that. You all know how we measure the temperature?
Saying?
No. Do you know? Oh, there are earthquakes here. Yeah, there are earthquakes here. All right. Yeah, so temperature. So what measures temperature, Ma?
Thermometer.
Yeah. So we have thermometer, seismometer, barometer. We have a lot of monitors.
Yeah.
All right. How are we doing on time now? All right, I think I made up. Thanks, Armand. I think I made up for the 3 minutes I was late getting set up here. So we talked about writing. What's that? Yeah, that makes two of us. So we got free writing with pencil, and then you can enable dictation, talk to text. We talked about different weather phenomena and how, I don't know, if students don't tell me what weather they want to be experts on, I'm just going to take something blindly and throw it in their box, and now they're going to be expert in heat waves.
That's right.
They got to read something. So either tell me.
They can write a little paragraph what they learned.
There you go. Oh, yeah, we're taking notes and doing all that stuff.
Yeah.
All right, so next time you and I talk, it'll be winter break.
Yeah. it'll be in the new year, right?
Oh, we'll talk before New Year's.
Oh, yeah, you and I.
Yeah, yeah. But, yeah, when we do this. No, that's okay. Will you? Can I challenge you? Can I challenge you to write a little bit about your squirrel?
I am.
And so you write about it, and then share it with me, and I'll share it with the kids so they can see the adventure. You've named the squirrel?
Michael, the grandson named it.
So Michael, my nephew Michael named the squirrel what?
Walter.
Walt.
Yes, and when Walter disappeared.
Okay.
And the other one that comes has a long skinny tail. And he named him Declevius. I don't know why.
Wow.
So there's Declevius, but Walter is back, and Walter hasn't been here for like 10 days.
Oh, maybe he's been hitting his other spots. Yeah. Storing up for the winter.
But I got a peanut, so in a shell. So now I think he'll be back.
Oh, yeah. How can you pass that up?
I know, right?
All right. Thanks, okay. Mom.
Merry Christmas and happy holidays to the kids.
Yeah. Love you.
Okay. Bye-bye.
All right. Thanks, everybody. Appreciate you all, those of you who were focused. All right. So have a good time with science. I'll see you later. All right. Aloha, everybody. Au revoir.